Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Well, I'm looking at the Drudge Report, drudgereport.com headlines, terror scare at Harvard during finals. Meanwhile, confidential Obamacare navigator training manual uploaded online. This just went up seconds ago. It refreshed and was there, red-linked. I'm going to print that and find out what's happening there. That's the torture of this job. I've got literally over 100 stories I want to get to. And then now the navigator manual has been leaked, and it's up at Capital City Project. By the way, these navigators, they've been hiring known criminal groups. They've been hiring known groups involved with all sorts of mafia ties and people that have been indicted for stealing millions, and they're getting your social security numbers, everything. Now it's being reported by KGW, as we got to yesterday, that people are trying to go sign up for these things and getting their bank accounts debited. Well, of course, it's getting all your private data. It's designed to be a giant screw job to see if they can get away with it. Oh, it's a mistake. Oh, I conked you on the head. Oh, you know, guy walks in, you're in bed with his wife, and you go, it's a mistake. I just fell into bed with your wife, and all of this is a horrible accident today. Also coming up, school bans display of Christmas poster. Kids are supposed to paint their own poster. It's your individual poster. As long as it's not obscene, that's your First Amendment. The school, if it's a government training camp, under their interpretation of separation of church and state, isn't supposed to endorse an official religion. You're not supposed to have a state-run religion. But you can bring a Bible to school. You can tell people out at the playground that you love Jesus Christ or that you love worshiping, you know, Chinese food if you want. I mean, it just that you hate Christmas, you love Christmas. It's your First Amendment. This political correctness is about banning any free speech, any personal views. So that is a big deal. School bans display of Christmas poster by student because it might be religious. And then folks don't even get that it's First Amendment. It has nothing to do with whether it's religious or not. Schools are trying to tell people they can't wear crosses around their necks. And look at it. It's actually not even really Christian. It says Merry Christmas. And then it's got that Night Before Christmas. Who's the guy that puts out all those kids' horror movies? Tim Burton. It's got the Tim Burton Christmas skeleton on it. So this kid's probably not even a Christian. And that's not even allowed, even though they'll show movies like that at the school. It's only when you individually do something, it's not allowed. When the state does it, it's all allowed. The state can be armed. You can't be armed. The state has its speech to demonize the founders, but you don't have any free speech. So we're going to be getting to all that. And we need an article out. Because this article that Steve Watson did is a great article that details what happened, but pointing out that you as an individual in your art class, if you're a Muslim, you can paint a picture of Mecca if they say paint whatever you want. If you're a Christian, you can paint a picture of a cross. If your dad's a Marine Corps captain and they say paint a picture of your parents, which is what happened in one case, and the honor student painted a picture of his father with an M16, he was arrested. There's been several of those cases. Arrested. Arrested. Oh my gosh, the image of a gun, we're arresting you. Kids have Nerf guns in their own backyards, they get arrested. And then, of course, here's the big story that's up on Infowars.com. Boston bomber believed he was a victim of mind control. That should probably be red-linked. That should probably be red-linked, folks. That is so bombshell. And Watson's got a little bit of this in his article, but he kind of goes with the news angle where he just reports the latest thing. We should probably add to the story, and I'm going to try to twist Watson's arm to come on at the bottom of the hour. Tamerlan Tsarnaev, on record, was in a State Department CIA-sponsored program being sent to Chechnya, and the FBI had him under close surveillance. Then they said they never heard of him. Remember that lie? Folks, he was clearly a double agent, bare minimum, and now he says he was mind controlled, and he is the exact type of candidate. Disappears for months on a government junket? That's when they do it to you. I mean, this is incredible.
The facts are in.
The wicked flee when none pursue, so the good book says. We are live, ladies and gentlemen, and broadcasting worldwide. There is total hysteria and fear and classes shut down at Harvard over a suspicious package or report of explosives, and they are, using this to make this the top story to project the idea that there is an epidemic of bombings and terror in this country. And, of course, the truth is you have a better chance of being killed by a deer jumping out in front of your car, being stung by a wasp, or being bit by a water moccasin and dying. Water moccasins kill hundreds every year, so do honeybees, than you do being killed by a terrorista. And then most of these events turn out to be mentally ill. Even the New York Times admits that. Literally 99% of the several hundred foiled bomb plots turn out to be FBI finding people with 70, 75, 80 IQs, low-grade morons, who are also mentally ill, and winding them up, black nationals, white nationals, Muslim extremists, whatever the case is, winding them up, commanding them, being their leader, recruiting them, introducing the idea to them. Folks, I could go, hypothetically, right now, but I wouldn't do a report like this because they could spin it and say that I was actually planning a terror attack, but I could go out and find schizophrenic homeless people in Austin right now, and offer them $10,000 to talk about how they're going to blow up a federal building or something, and then I could have them meet me the next day there to drive a van to it, filled with chocolate cakes or something. Guaranteed. It's that easy. I might check with lawyers and even call the FBI and tell them I'm going to do it, just so it's all on record so they don't claim I'm doing something, just to have them stop doing this. And, of course, the argument here is that they're doing this to foil attacks. Well, if somebody saw their neighbor talking about blowing something up and then saw them doing something in their garage that looked like explosives with barrels or something, that's probable cause, SWAT team and find out what's going on. Or if somebody really was shooting their mouth off about, I want to kill people and blow stuff up, and then the FBI came to them and said, yeah, we ought to do that, and then gave them a bomb, that would still be kind of entrapment, but it might be legal in some arguments. I get the fact that if you think somebody's already doing something, bring it up to them to see what they're up to. That's a classic police tactic for thousands of years. But it's not legal or lawful to go out and find mentally ill people and do this. So it's particularly disgusting and shameful to have this going on. And the truth is, it's come out now that the majority, the vast majority, of these plots turn out to be staged. And this is how they absolutely hype the living daylights out of it. Look at the headlines on drudgereport.com right now. Terror scare at Harvard during finals. And then under it, confidential Obamacare navigator training manual uploaded online. That just went live minutes ago. We're going to cover that. Separately under it, our Infowars.com story. Boston bomber believed he was victim of mind control. Ladies and gentlemen, this just went from absolutely evidence that this was a staged event, overwhelming evidence with the drills and the stand downs and the older brother being on the CIA payroll. Oh, that came out in the foreign press. British, Russian. It was confirmed he had a fake name. The Russian embassy said, is this guy a spy? They did this 3 years ago, 2 years before the bombing. They said, is this guy a spy for you? Because you let him fly with a fake name. And he's going to Chechnya and hanging out with rebels. And we know you run those rebels on record. Our government and NATO run the al-Qaeda forces in the Balkans and into the southern belly of Russia, into the Caucasus. That's all on record. A few months ago, the head of Saudi intelligence, Bandar, threatened publicly in Moscow at a meeting and said, we will trigger al-Qaeda to blow up the Olympics if you don't back off and do a peace deal in Syria. That's how dumb they think Westerners are, is that the Saudis can publicly threaten to activate al-Qaeda forces against the Russians and send in people like Tamerlan Tsarnaev. We don't know if he was a triple-crosser, double-agent, triple-agent, set up, not set up. All we know is there was a drill of bombs going off at the finish line, and that's been confirmed. All we know is there was a stand down. All we know is the FBI lied and said, we don't know who Tamerlan Tsarnaev is, when it turns out he was being handled by them, surveilled by them, followed in with a whole community in Florida and in Georgia and in New York and New Jersey and in Boston, Massachusetts. He was all over the country with Playboy glasses on and expensive $1,000 jackets on, driving brand new Mercedes Benzes without a job, being playboys, obviously some type of intelligence asset. And then he told friends, the Boston Globe now reports, he told friends, I'm under mind control. Folks, it's not like he's a schizophrenic on the street corner saying this. This guy fits the look, the musculature. A guy that thinks he's a commando, a kickboxer, they recruit him, a narcissism, the whole nine yards for a decoy candidate for a born supremacy, born legacy type program. And by the way, those programs are declassified. The earlier programs, they had total mind control power by the 70s when they had the church hearings and others. Total mind control if they pick the right type of candidate. Other people will run off, go crazy, or kill themselves if they have a high moral fiber and are not narcissist. But with narcissists and those that already are mentally ill, they can break up their personalities with electroshock, drugs, all the rest of it. This is a complex area. There's a lot of different sciences that go into it. I'm just a lay researcher of it. They are able to absolutely imprint them with the program that they're basically a movie star doing this, and they feel so happy and so excited when they carry out the terror attack. Just like in the remake of The Manchurian Candidate with Denzel Washington, excellent film. You want to know mind control? That's how they do it. And when he gets the keywords, he smiles, feels great, and is a movie star. And it's the same deal with this hypnotism that they do under drugs, electroshock. And that's old technology, folks. The stuff they've got now is viruses they inject that literally attack areas of the brain so you don't have inhibition. Then they give them amnesiacs to wipe that. Then they give them an amnesiac again to trigger the operation. Sirhan, it came out in the police reports, was under mind control, given a proto-Halcyon-type drug. That's the patsy shooter of RFK, who was the cover guy for Robert F. Kennedy. And then they had a known CIA agent behind him. The police even on record said that's where the shots came from, that shot him in the back. Look it up, folks. It's all on record. It's actually all come out. That's what's so frustrating about all this. Theodore Kaczynski, the Unabomber, was in MK Ultra, LA Times. Look it up. Alexander Cockburn, award-winning journalist, broke that. The documents were leaked and then declassified fully. The fact that he was in the program. He was in the program for a decade as a student, graduate student, and then adjunct. Kaczynski, total cutout setup. Who else said he was under mind control? Holmes, ladies and gentlemen, the so-called Batman shooter. Didn't know who he was when the SWAT team showed up. Clearly drugged. Put next to cells, saying, flipping out on drugs for 2 days, saying, I'm under mind control, help me, they did it. He checked himself in, his dad, top algorithm scientist in the government and private corporations. He goes into an advanced DARPA, above Air Force level program, run by the Air Force, but Space Command, mind control, astronaut brain interface, where the astronauts think and it controls the suits. He goes into an advanced brain machine mind control interface. This is on record. Has an Air Force colonel over him. He's full-time paid in a national top secret security level program. And goes from being a kid genius to having red hair and going and shooting people, even though they reported multiple shooters, smoke, all of it, people announcing, stay in your chairs, everything's safe. It was totally rigged. And he's out in the parking lot drooling. And then when it came out that all these people came out of the jail and said he was saying he was under mind control, he was screaming and they took him away. The police came out and said, we're sealing all that, but he was always in solitary around no one. He was never in a general area where anyone could hear him, even though it had been in the paper earlier that they talked to the police who weren't part of it. The jail guard said, yeah, he was screaming, he was yelling, saying he was under mind control. It's not like it's only happening a few places here. Tamerlan Tsarnaev, was in a Georgetown State Department CIA program on record, undoubtedly. And the media here will not touch it. He's flying by fake names. Would you like me to continue, folks? Would you like me to continue going down the line? Ladies and gentlemen, you could take one look at Adam Lanza and all his government connections and his family. And one look at him trying to get guns five times. And one look at the stand down and the man caught with a gun in the woods in camo and black top that matched Lanza. And all the rest of it. They killed real people there and now they bulldozed the building. Wasn't all actors, but you watch it, folks, it's undoubtedly actors coming out laughing, going, watch this, and then doing their fake cry over and over again, and then kids that were photographed coming out still alive. They are running major psyops. And you're like, well, why actually kill real people then? But then have actors. You want the actors to put out your official story and not come out and say, oh, I'm pro-gun, I'm sorry my kid's dead, but don't blame gun owners. These are major, 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 major psyops being run. And Paul Watson's coming up to break it down. But that story's on Infowars.com right now. Boston Bomber believed he was a victim of mind control. And folks, remember, we sent our reporter to those press conferences to bring up the drills and to bring up the other people with backpacks, and the police would freak out covering it up. Well, folks, last week, Russian government officially threatened to nuke Western Europe and the United States if offensive missiles are moved into their areas meant to be able to shoot down their response to a preemptive nuclear attack. Official U.S. policy under the New World Order has changed in the last decade to preemptive strikes, telling Russia and China, we may decide to attack you with nuclear weapons at any time. So Russia and China, and I'm not romanticizing them, they're other big predatory power blocks, they said, okay, we reserve the right to nuke you first as well. And so their deputy prime minister came out officially and said, we will respond with nukes. That is a quote. Now it is being reported that Russia is moving missiles into its western region, bordering Poland and other nations. The exact missiles, the Iskander missile system, is being moved in. Russia has deployed the missiles with a range of hundreds of kilometers in the Baltic Sea enclave of Kaliningrad, which borders NATO members Poland, Lithuania, the newspapers are reporting today. The paper reports came after German newspaper Bild reported on Saturday that secret satellite imagery showed the Iskander M missiles stationed near the Polish border. The reports caused alarm in the Baltic states, which are wary of Russian military movements after decades of dominance by the Soviet Union. Well, why? I mean, the West is moving missiles in to the Russian border. Why should you be alarmed? Why should we be alarmed about giant war tanks and armored vehicles and bullets and training manuals that it's for the American people are being massed all around us? Why should we be alarmed they're putting in an NSA surveillance grid and spying on us illegally and putting fluoride in the water and bisphenol A in the plastic and admitting it's to dumb us down and sterilize us? Why should we be concerned about the big banks saying they'll just take our bank accounts or take our private and public pension funds? Or why should we be worried about the Federal Reserve devaluing the dollar and gearing up for total war with us? I mean, never mind these anti-missile missiles and anti-personnel missiles and missiles that can carry nuclear warheads, medium-range and short-range strategic nuclear weapons. Big deal! What's the big deal? It's kind of like in Caddyshack where Bill Murray's dropping the plastic explosive gophers and squirrels and rabbits. He's like, nothing to worry about, Mr. Gopher. Just your friend the squirrel. Not a plastic explosive or anything. I mean, this is what's going on as we're all being surrounded by tyranny. And look, I don't live in Russia. I don't live in China. I don't like their tyrannies. But they're not offensive tyrannies like our government is. Because our government's been captured by the globalist and is absolutely savaging our basic freedoms and needs to be put back on a leash. It's like Napoleon or Hitler or Genghis Khan or Julius Caesar involved in these offensive operations that we pay for that don't even benefit us and that endanger the entire world. So a bunch of crazy globalist bankers can make the planet accept their global cashless society, and so they can take over the planet. Everybody wants to rule the world, the song says. Well, I don't. I just want to have a future. And I am sick and tired of these globalists. And I know you're sick and tired of them as well. And I hope that cooler heads prevail, but this is very, very worrisome. Poland is freaking out. Reuters is reporting. Poland is worried about the possibility that Russia has deployed the missiles to the Baltic enclave of Kaliningrad and will consult its NATO partners on the issue, the foreign ministry said today. The plans to deploy the new Iskander M rockets to Kaliningrad are worrying. The Russians said last year they'd do that if they move missiles in. You move missiles up to our border, we move missiles up to your border. The ministry said in a statement, commenting on reports in Russia, a German media said the missiles had been deployed. Folks, imagine if you walked outside and your neighbor was pointing a gun at you for no reason. You would call the police. But if you lived out in the frontier, you couldn't call the police, or it's another government. They are the police. They're pointing a gun at you. And so you start saying, okay, honey, kids, go out the back door, drive out the back, don't drive out the front, or don't go in the front yard or the backyard, wherever the gun's aimed at you. And you put a gun up aiming out your window at them. See, we're losing the moral high ground. The globalists run our country now, and they're moving missiles in and pointing them at the Russians so that when cruise missiles or bombers or ICBMs come in, the Russians can't fire their anti-missile systems at them. And the Russians can't get their missiles in a counter-response back. They're being moved into check and then checkmate. And so the Russians are saying, okay, well, we're going to move. You know, the Russians know how to play chess, folks. Most of the world champions come out of Russia. They go, I mean, this is like checkers, though. You move missiles up to us, we move missiles up to you. Why did the Russians try to put missiles in Cuba? Because the West put nuclear missiles in Turkey. It's the same deal. So that's what's going on here, ladies and gentlemen. We'll be back with Paul Watson and the latest on the Boston Bomber. By the way, I haven't even gotten to this article yet. I'm going to cover it after Paul Watson leaves us. Then we're going to open the phones up and cover news to balance the transmission. Documents reveal states move to vastly expand continuity of government powers. That's a Mikhail Thalen report up on Infowars.com and Prisonplanet.com, originally originating at StoryLeak.com. And this document out of Washington State talks about warfare with the American people and says Washington Military Department, the state has a military department, modernizing state's continuity of operation planning. And again, it always has the cover of emergencies, and this is an inside document. But the larger issue in all this is that they want to amend the state constitution to basically suspend rights. So it's the phasing in of martial law. And I have great writers, great researchers. The problem is they tend to not even go all the way when something's really happening because it's almost journalistic to hold back. But the only way you can name this, the only way you can accurately say what it is state moves to repeal due process or state moves towards martial law, permanent martial law. I mean, that's what it is. They want to get rid of due process during COG. Well, there's already plans in place if there was a real COG issue, like a nuclear attack or a volcano going off. This is the opposite, folks. This is all about political control. And it's happening not just here, but in Japan and in Russia and in China and in England and in Germany and all over South Africa and all over Latin America. Governments everywhere have made conscious decisions to move towards authoritarianism. And there's battles now for the undersea floor and minerals. There's battles for the North Pole and the South Pole now, politically, as governments line up and declare they own them. There's battles with China declaring the moon is theirs. And this is the same type of stuff you see with the South China Sea fights between China and between Japan and now South Korea. All of this is heating up because you have global devaluation of currencies. All the major governments, whether it's the yuan or whether it's the yen or whether it is the Russian currency or the euro currency or the dollar, they're all set to dollars worldwide. And so they're all racing each other on who can inflate the currencies the fastest. And when the musical chair stops and the hand grenade that's being passed around blows up, it's going to cause a chain reaction. And I don't know how bad it's going to be. I don't know exactly what's going to happen because they've got computers, gaming and all, and over the horizon, future predicting mass models where they can have a controlled implosion and the system can guide it for themselves. The system can use the calamities in their own words and their own documents to bring in the total tyranny worldwide. So I was on Ron Paul's TV show this morning, and he kept hammering the fact that we've got to blame the collectivist, the corporatist, the crony capitalist, the insiders for what they've done, because they're going to try to bring in total tyranny on the backs of the crises that they've helped engineer. Don't let a good crisis go to waste. In fact, engineer the crisis to take over. That's the plan. And so this is now the fight. This is so huge, what's going on, what's happening. And you've got all these different governments lining up for a fight right now, and you've got the globalists who have interest in every country playing us all off against each other, and Russia moving in nuclear-tipped missiles to fast attack Europe with these Iskander missiles that anti-missile defense systems cannot stop, according to what they claim. So this is what the establishment is doing. And they will threaten the whole world and bring us to the brink of thermonuclear war to basically intimidate different political classes into doing what the New World Order wants. And the New World Order is the Anglo-American establishment that used the West wealth and liberty to build the greatest tyranny, because liberty builds wealth, and they skimmed off the wealth of liberty to build a tyranny. Now they're getting ready to phase out the engine of liberty that built their empire to secure their dominance over us while they launch out to take over what's left of the world from other criminal predatory groups, the Russians, the Chinese power blocks. And we are all stuck in the middle of this. And whether you're Russian, Chinese, or American, or British, we're all human beings. We all love our children. Let me ask men a question. Do you find Russian beauties particularly beautiful? Why don't you want to love the Russian people instead of kill them? Russians love American cowboy culture and fast cars and James Dean and all the rest of it. Why don't we be friends with the Russians? Well, the globalists don't want us to do that. That's why they put the communist in 1917 to make that place 10 times worse. They took the czarist evil and put something 10 times worse in. I don't support the czarists, the white Russians. That was a tyranny as well. Just like I don't support apartheid, but I don't support communism, something even more scientifically evil in place of it. So see, there's the difference, ladies and gentlemen, and we owe Russia an apology for letting the robber barons, who couldn't capture us completely because we had checks and balances and Americans wouldn't put up with it. Americans had shooting wars with the feds and with Pinkerton Security and all the rest of them out west and all over the country when they tried to enslave us. You see that in all these movies like Open Range and stuff. That's based on basically true stories. There were thousands of fights like that. So they couldn't dominate us, but there was already a centralized empire in Russia. There was already a centralized tyranny ready to fall over, rotting. And so they came over and put commies in. And that's what they do. They use the depression in Russia to put communists in. They use the collapsing China after a six-year war with the Japanese. It was going on before World War II even started, to come in and then put Mao Zedong. We owe the Chinese people an absolute apology for letting the robber barons use us as a base, use our tax money, our troops, our intelligence to bring down Russia, to bring down China, and set in its place horrible, demonic, goblin-like governments who would make deals with them. I mean, unbelievable. Unbelievable evil. 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 And that's the truth of the world, folks. That's the real geopolitical setup right now. They don't want mainline secular Muslims, secular government in the Middle East. They want Al-Qaeda chopping women's private parts off, running around, blowing stuff up, pulling down monuments, burning up libraries. That's what they're going to put. They want degradation. They want collapse. While they sit in Switzerland and Luxembourg and London and New York City and in armored redoubts in the Bahamas and in Tasmania and in the Cook Islands, the globalists want to sit there while they wreck the world and play us all off against each other. I got an idea. How about we wake up and say, no, humanity's going to the stars. We're working together under true free market. We're going to honor and make rock stars, scientists and inventors and good fathers and good mothers. We're going to build up men. We're going to build up women. We're going to build up the family. We're going to have space colonies. We're going to work globally together through national nation states and true diversity, but combining together in a 1776 worldwide liberty conference to decide on the goals of the nation states moving forward together. It could be held once a year in a great two-week congress for agreed upon goals, and then go back to the nation states and see if they agree and unify humanity around goals and around human empowerment. The opposite of what they want to unify us under, tyranny and evil and degradation and a future without humanity, where the elite control the future and merge with machines and believe they're God. They have no right to govern our destiny. They have no spiritual right. They have no moral right. They are the last people that should be governing our destiny. They are a danger to everyone on this planet, and when they've committed crimes, they need to be locked up, not running society. I'm going to go to Paul Watson here in a moment with huge breaking news. But first, we are listener supported, ladies and gentlemen. And you have supported us behind the books, the t-shirts, the films that are all about waking people up, all about spreading the word, all about finding local patriots in your area, all about wearing your colors proud, maiden1776.com. Infowarsstore.com with all the Made in America shirts, all the, you know, the hats, all of it. We now have the American A Wake Up Patriot Blend and the Immune Support Blend from my favorite place to get coffee, High Mountains in Chiapas, southern Mexico. Better than Guatemalan, in my view. Very affordably priced. Your purchase of the coffee supports the operation. We have the Survival Shield 1 ounce Super Nascent Iodine. Double the amount at half the cost of leading competitors. $29.95 in stock, ready to ship to you by Christmas if you order by the 19th. We have the 2 ounce, double the size bottle of Fluoride Shield that has nascent iodine and five other ingredients that fuse together to absolutely detoxify from all the research we've done. But be careful when you start detoxifying. Consult a physician beforehand, but it's amazing. And that's available. That's available right now. When you buy two, you get it for $34.95. That's double the amount for $10 more, or double the amount when you buy two for $5 more per bottle. InfoWarsLife.com, InfoWarsLife.com. Or you can simply call toll-free 888-253-3139. And lastly, you can also go to InfoWarsStore.com or InfoWarsLife.com. We'll take you there as well. And get ProPure 10% off the best gravity-fed filters out there. And give it as a gift or a gift to your own family. Cuts out the glyphosates, the fluoride, you name it. Promo code WATER to save 10% off. And it is your purchases and your support that make it all possible. You can also give PrisonPlanet.tv memberships to see the nightly news and so much more. One membership is really 11 memberships, $5.95 a month, or sign up for a year and get 5-plus months free, PrisonPlanet.tv. All right, let's go to Paul Watson. His story is the top story on Infowars.com. And it's also on drudgereport.com in the middle column. Boston bomber believes he was a victim of mind control. Boston bomber believes he was a victim of mind control. Now, here is Paul Watson. This is in the Boston Globe, but Paul Watson gives background. The Unabomber was under CIA mind control. That came out in the LA Times. The supposed Aurora shooter said he was under mind control. And now it comes out in the Boston Globe. He believed he was under mind control. Folks, he was under a CIA-funded program to Chechnya. This is literal born supremacy type stuff. This is amazing. Paul Watson, thank you for joining us.
Good to be here, Alex.
Break it down, my friend.
Yeah, this is the result of a five-month investigation by the Boston Globe, and they basically talked to a whole host of people who intimately knew the Tsarnaev brothers. One of them, Donald Larking, a 67-year-old who attended the Boston Mosque with Tamerlan Tsarnaev, told the Boston Globe he believed in majestic mind control, which is a way of breaking down a person and creating an alternative personality with which they must coexist. You can give a signal, a phrase, or a gesture and bring out the alternate personality and make them do things. Tamerlan thought someone might have done that to him. So they're talking about trigger phrases, trigger words, trigger images and symbols that make people do violent actions as a result of mind control. Which, as you just mentioned, in the case of James Holmes, the Batman shooter, he said to an inmate of his that he was, quote, programmed to carry out the massacre by an evil therapist who brainwashed him with the aid of neuro-linguistic programming. So again, we're talking about trigger phrases used to turn one to shift from one personality to another that's been created by mind control, which is interesting because we know that Holmes, immediately before the massacre began, took a phone call, was talking to somebody on the phone, then began with the shooting. Now, there was a British program, a television special, which aired a few years ago in the UK by quite a famous hypnotist called Derren Brown. And he was able to actually brainwash somebody, mind control them to carry out an assassination, which the subject thought was real, an assassination of a famous person in public. And the trigger for carrying out that assassination was a woman dressed in a polka dot skirt. So when it actually came to the assassination, the woman walked in the polka dot dress. And this individual, who beforehand was completely calm and normal, who thought that he was just attending a theater show, pulled out a gun and assassinated in his own mind. The shots were obviously blanks, but he thought he was really assassinating a public figure. So these trigger words, these trigger images are proven in MK Ultra CIA mind control lore to actually work, and they can actually create these mind control assassins, which of course happened in the case of Sirhan Sirhan and the assassination of RFK.
And by the way, this is not our opinion now. Again, it came out in the LA Times, you might add this, that Theodore Kaczynski on record was in the MK Ultra program. And so undoubtedly, they're bare minimum using it to have them there drugged out of their minds to blame them for things that later happen, but to also carry out attacks. And because the general public's been mesmerized by television and is generally already in a near sleepwalking haze. People say the public's in a haze. You can't get through to them. Because if you watch 3-4 hours of television a day, you literally go into a zombified state. That's why children, you can't talk to them if they're watching TV. You're like, hey, don't you hear me? Their mouths are hanging open. The flicker rate is set just like a flashing light to literally put them into that state. So the public is so weak-minded now that, as you pointed out, hypnotists can find highly suggestible people and have them commit assassinations just off hypnotism. You add drugs. And of course, this guy was under a top Air Force colonel in a brain interface DARPA program. Now imagine, you get put into this, you get hypnotized, next you're drugged. They sealed his notebook. They've declared national security on that. I mean, Paul, there's really no doubt now. But again, they know the public's so dumb, they're hiding this in plain view, Paul. I mean, this is unbelievable.
Well, I mean, talk about hiding it in plain view. You remember the guy they arrested during the manhunt for the Boston bombers, the so-called naked guy who was supposed to be a different person? You can see clearly that it's Tamerlan Tsarnaev. They arrested him. He was completely unharmed, uninjured. And then, you know, a few hours later, he died in a police shootout. See his autopsy photos. He's riddled with bullet holes.
And
his
I predicted they'd try to kill the other brother, which they knew was in the boat. They shot it. And by the grace of God, they only hit him a few times. He got out. Then I said, oh my gosh, they're gonna shut him up. And then they did. But still, he's saying he didn't do it. He says not guilty.
And the friend of the bombers, Todashev, you know, they went, held him in his own apartment for 5 days, interrogated him. And then just shot him in the head, claimed he lunged at them with a knife, later had to admit that was completely made up, and just no explanation, just shot him in the head. He was an eyewitness to what went on. So
this is literally the Bourne legacy. This is literally the Bourne legacy. This is literal mind control out in the open targeting the dumbed down general public. They know we know. We know the drill. We know how they did it. We know he was CIA. The little brother was, oh my gosh, stay there, Paul. This is so evil, ladies and gentlemen. They wanna control mankind. That's Stephen Marley bringing us in.
Mind control.
And again, there's hundreds of different types of mind control. From just advertising down to conditioning down to drugging. And it's on record they're drugging most of the U.S. troops now in combat with all sorts of psychotropic speed drugs, hallucinogens, not just the amphetamines, but the opiates to then have them all strung out and screwed up so they can then control them and say, oh, you want pain pills for your depression? And then list them as drug addicts and then remove their Second Amendment once they get out of the military. But this is the type of intel that we now have that can turn this around. And look, the average person in the FBI, the average person even in the CIA, is totally compartmentalized. And it's not even a bad person either. They don't like what's going on. This is really evil, what's happening. It's a very small group doing this, and we have to become aware of it and boldly expose it or we have no future. Paul Watson of PrisonPlanet.com and Infowars.com. Breaking this down here today, we have the other angle of who they're picking for their mind control. And it's clear if you go back, it's the same story with the situation at Littleton. Clearly, they had a federal mind control program under death education going on there. Half the school was empty that day. There were 247 bombs found in the building. CBS News, that got covered up. They were supposed to kill hundreds. They got set up. There were other shooters. They admit the SWAT team shot several of the kids. Rocky Mountain News. Media works to keep mass shooters' profile secret. The profile is a video game head goth who's into the occult, who they then grab and program because they're already unstable and ready. Separately, though, or their research students in advanced secret programs, the Unabomber, Theodore Kaczynski, Holmes from Colorado, Aurora, that's the other MO. They get research college students, Tamerlan Tsarnaev. He was in a research program sent by the State Department out of that key command base there in D.C., Georgetown. And you've got that in your article. So, Paul, this is really amazing. They either get drughead, devil worshipers that already play 10 hours a day of video games. Trying to talk fast, folks, and messing up, trying to get to it all here, who are devil worshipers and already on drugs and are naturally programmed by kind of the ambient brainwashing system, or they get people in research programs as their cover. Paul Watson.
Well, the question is, Alex, why do they need to stage all this? Well, it's for the security state. They need these incidents to keep the level of fear-mongering high so the general public will accept the kind of security measures that companies linked to the military-industrial complex make massive profits out of, and the government itself gets more power out of it. If there weren't these kind of incidents, their slush fund would be instantly terminated. And, it stretches back all the way to Sirhan Sirhan, because 3 months before RFK was assassinated, he disappeared for 3 months, Sirhan Sirhan, in the hands of this, psychologist working for the CIA, who actually later turned up dead himself in a hotel room of a suspected suicide. So the people who are actually doing the brainwashing end up dead as well. But then you've got that whole investigation into, the two shooters at the RFK assassination, Sirhan Sirhan being in a trance before he pulled the trigger, and his lawyers, with increasing conviction, are proving the fact that he was probably the first mind control patsy. And as you said, it's not always people who go out and do the killings. It's the need to create patsies so then the actual operation can take place.
Stay there. Do 5 more minutes with us, and I'm giving the number out and taking calls. Yeah, here's the Daily Mail. Bobby Kennedy's assassin still claims he was a victim of mind control and his gun didn't fire a fatal shot. A new appeal after parole is denied. He doesn't claim that. The local police report said it was a different caliber shot RFK in the back of the neck and head. And at the same time, his gun got pinned by a bystander. And the guy that shot RFK in the back was a CIA Skunk Works worker. That's a secret aircraft facility worker. And at the same time, 3 famous CIA agents were later documented to be in the crowd at the ballroom right before this happened. So obviously they'd killed his brother, the president. They were going to kill him. Watson, in the 3-4 minutes we've got left in this short segment, he was seen with the lady in the polka dot dress. She gives him a drink, obviously, of some type of amnesiac. He's given his programming cue, and he goes and then plays the part of the patsy. That's where you left off.
Yeah, that's what I was saying with the television show. They recreated that almost exactly, the girl with the polka dot dress. She was the trigger for him to go and pull the actual trigger and be the patsy for the assassination. And then, of course, the Church Committee and Rockefeller Commission investigations in 75 were preceded 2 years beforehand by CIA Director Richard Helms ordering the destruction of all files related to MKUltra in 1973, 2 years before these investigations took place. So whereas a lot of information about them came out from whistleblowers, most of the actual physical evidence was destroyed by the CIA 2 years beforehand. So it's amazing. But the other point you made before the break was, you know, you're in the FBI, not the lower level FBI aren't involved in this kind of thing. That was brought home to me today. There's a CBS News interview with the NSA. They got inside access to the NSA building and they were like, this is not going to be a puff piece. Of course, it was a total puff piece. But they were asking the director of the NSA questions, Alexander. And in one case, they asked him a question about Snowden and he had to turn around and ask somebody in, quote, the shadowy group of figures behind him, if it was okay for him to talk about a certain issue relating to Snowden. So the director of the NSA is having to ask his superiors in the NSA permission to speak about a certain subject on CBS News, and he's supposed to be the top guy. So there are guys above him. So again, it brings
home
the point.
Top guys don't, in most cases, know anything that's going on. I mean, that's on record. That's how the globalists run these operations.
They just read the teleprompters.
That's right. You've got permanent members in the shadow government burrowed in like ticks.
And those are the kind of guys who are going to be involved in MKUltra and these programs. That's why they destroy the files before they can be properly investigated. But again, with Jared Lee Loeffner, the gunman who shot Gabby Giffords, he was obsessed with mind control. And then you tie that in with the psychiatric drugs, which induce violence. And, you know, it's a cocktail for carnage, basically.
Well, here's the deal. The shoot 'em up video games, and the video game heads get mad at me when I say this. I'm not saying take away your murder training tools. My whole point is First Amendment. You've got a right to it. I have a right. They think censorship is disagreeing with them. No, censorship is stopping you. The shoot 'em up games were invented to create instinctive shooting, to create killing machines. You put devil-worshipping people on serotonin reuptake inhibitors that make you kill people on this. It makes you a programmed assassin. These games were made to program Marine Corps and Army killers to instinctively kill. Then the government takes kids that already fit the profile, drug them up even more, and point them at the target. It's very simple.
And that's why they use them for drone pilots as well.
That's right. They recruit their drone pilots out of the pool of video game heads, just like The Last Starfighter, just like Ender's Game. They had declassified plans before those movies and books came out in the 80s that was what video games were for, to have interactive giant game grids to pick the people they want for the future and to train the computers. The computers are all wargaming what you do. You won't be needed in the future. In the last 50 years, iodine has been... Folks, we're now into the second hour. Thank you so much for joining us on this Monday, 16th day of December, 2013. The news websites are Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com. You can follow me specifically on Twitter at RealAlexJones. I want to open the phones up today. And when I say first-time callers, I really mean first-time callers. And then in the next hour, I'll have a free-for-all. But I want to give first-time callers out there, we don't screen your calls, we just ask you have a good telephone and get to your point. Call in and give us your take on everything we just covered in the last hour. The fact that the Boston Globe is now reporting that the supposed lead Boston bomber, Tamerlan Tsarnaev, believed that he was under MKUltra mind control. Ladies and gentlemen, he was under a secret State Department program run by the CIA out of Georgetown University to send him to be with Chechen rebels in Chechnya. That is in the major British and German newspapers. months ago. There was a drill of a bombing at the Boston Marathon that was used to have everybody in place. In case anybody got caught carrying it out, they would just say it was part of a drill. You had the stand down of the police. You had all the other people with the backpacks. You had the cover up. This is really incredible when you add to it all the other bombers and people and all the other mass shooters who, it turns out, were in CIA programs. And this comes out, and then literally no one gets in trouble. There are no investigations. Remember, the FBI lied and said, we don't know who Tamerlan Tsarnaev was. We never heard of him. Turned out, I said 2 years. It was actually 3 years before. They were in contact with him, in meetings with him, debriefing him about his trips to Chechnya. And the family is on record saying that he was basically working for the government. And then I call the family back, the aunt and others, and they start crying and have basically been threatened. Yes, I'm ready to come on your show. Call back 20 minutes later. My children, no, they will get them. They will smash me, they said. No. I mean, this is the life I live, living in the real world, ladies and gentlemen. And now the Boston Globe's reporting this. I'd like to get your take on it. 800-259-9231. 800-259-9231. Then there's stuff like this. We covered it last week and played part of the TV ad they're running, and it's also running in England before movies. But Greenpeace uses depressed Santa to claim North Pole is melting, and he's in there with blinking lights in a basement in a bunker, and there's water running. He goes, the North Pole has melted. Oh, my God, it's the end of the world. Now they have billboards up that we have a photo of on Infowars.com. Greenpeace uses depressed Santa to claim North Pole is melting. Arctic ice has actually increased 29% since last summer. And if you scroll down, there is a NOAA weather NASA satellite showing it from August 27th of last year to August 15, 2013. The ice, ladies and gentlemen, has massively, massively increased. In fact, the thickness has increased, and they debate whether it's increased 30-something percent or 50-something percent. And they argue about it all day. But let's read some of this. Greenpeace is running ads in major transportation hubs around the world featuring an image of a depressed Santa. This was with record cold temperatures in Antarctica, 138 below zero. This is with record cold temperatures across Europe, across the United States. Greenpeace is running ads in major transportation hubs around the world featuring an image of a depressed Santa Claus alongside the words, the North Pole is melting, you better believe it. You better believe it. That's how dumb they think you are, is that they run people under CIA programs. The Boston lead bomber suspect, the one they tried to kill, has said, I'm not guilty, and they are saying national security on what he's saying. I know what it's saying. My brother was in the government, was set up. Because we know he was in the government. And now he told his friends and family, I was under mind control. That's coming out in the trial, the secret trial of his brother. It's coming out. And I can't believe the Boston Globe actually told the truth about this. Good job, Boston Globe. Because most people aren't in on this, folks. We're just ignorant and don't want to admit where we're at. They're telling you that polar bears can't swim. Penguins can't swim at the South Pole. Polar bears can't swim at the North Pole. The ice is all melted. They'll point cameras at icebergs and say, look, it all melted. They're floating. There's always icebergs coming off in the spring and summer and fall. This is how dumb they think you are. I mean, look at this. If you're a radio listener, go to Infowars.com. You can see it. The photo above, taken at London Underground Station by Watson, encourages people to donate £3 or almost $6 to the charity to help save the Arctic and get a message from Santa. However, just like Father Christmas, the claim that the North Pole is melting is a complete myth. From the summer of 2012 to 2013, the Arctic ice sheet increased by an area of 533,000 square miles, a rise of 29%. That is an extremely low estimate. NASA's imagery released earlier this year illustrated how, at the height of summer, an ice sheet more than half the size of Europe stretched from Canada to Russia. The following claims by scientists in 2007 reported by BBC that the Arctic ice would be ice-free by the summer of 2013 have been proven manifest fraud. Now, I want to explain something. Every year in the summer, they go, by next year, it'll be entirely melted. And they show it in the summer, not telling you that the Arctic has a summer and a winter, shrinking. Ships thousands of years ago up in the Baltic and, you know, the Vikings could go up where northern Russia is during the summer. It was a summer passage. It always, in recorded history, thaws. They have icebreakers to go into areas they can't normally get into. This is literally like people not knowing what planet we're on. That's how dumb they are. They have a mythical Santa Claus in TV ads and in billboards saying, quote, "The North Pole is melting. You'd better believe it." Greenpeace, who said it would be entirely gone right now. And it is the biggest recorded in more than 50 years. Because the sun is at the low of a 100-year cycle. And they're concerned because their data is showing it may be the lowest output from old sun since we began recording it. And they've been recording that for more than 300 years. The sun, I don't care if the UN has a vote and says that the sun does not affect climate. That is like saying water does not affect fish. That is like saying sunlight is not needed for photosynthesis in plants. And, I mean, I just can't believe the propaganda is so dumbed down that a mythical character is telling you that the North Pole has completely melted and you, quote, better believe it. You better, just like Obama would say, period, you better believe it. I will keep this promise. You will not lose your doctor. Your premium will not go up. There are no death panels. You will lose your premium. I mean, it will go up. You will lose your doctor. There are death panels. And I literally am on Twitter, and I saw some guy yesterday going, "You're a racist, Alex." And the story was about how the white shooter in Colorado was an avowed socialist who went in to kill conservative members of the debate team. And I went and looked. It was a real Twitter account. It was a real black guy in the Marines. And he was saying, you know, "You're a racist. Basically, your time's coming." Imagine. Imagine you oppose a socialist going in with a shotgun to shoot people he disagrees with, a white person, and it's racist. I mean, no wonder they're telling people that Santa Claus is real and the North Pole's going to melt. Or has melted and he's in a bunker. I mean, it's just, they think you are so stupid. They think you are so dumb. And because they know you're not really dumb. You buy into something and you then see it as a possession. You don't want to admit that you've been conned, if you're a mainline Republican or mainline Democrat. You don't want to admit their corrupt special interests ruling your life. I admit it. I want out from under them. Let me tell you, some bully sitting on top of me, punching me in the face, I'm not going to deny I'm getting punched in the face. I'm going to try to get out of it. I mean, I just have a lot of trouble dealing with this level of begging to be enslaved. And listen, here's the issue. Just because you want to be enslaved and feel intellectually superior and call me racist when I'm the opposite of that, doesn't mean you get to wreck my life. Doesn't mean you get to pass forced inoculation laws they're trying to pass in New York right now. Well, it has passed. They're just trying to implement it now. It doesn't mean I've got to work and pay 60%+ of what I produced for you. It doesn't mean I've got to believe what you believe or worship the gods you want to worship or not worship. I'm an individual. Get that through your brain. I belong to me and myself and my family and God. My body belongs to me. And I am sick and tired of your tyranny dressed up as liberalism when you people are the opposite of liberals. You people are the opposite. I see so-called liberals make fun of the unborn. You say, well, what about my body, heaven rights? It's another human, especially by the last trimester. And people make jokes about killing that baby and ah-ha-ha, and I had an abortion, and it's fun to do, and, you know, kill that little parasite and all this stuff. That's what the top feminists all celebrate and demonize the baby, celebrate killing the babies. Is that liberal? Hell, even if you're going to kill the baby, why celebrate it? Because you people are evil. You people are devil worshipers. I know who you are. You so-called atheists that are statist, you're into power, so you chose Satanism. It's all about your personal power over other people to take their free will and enslave them. You're a bunch of would-be dungeon keepers, and I see exactly what you are. And you will be defeated. Your calls, Bill, James, Nancy, Colt, Jim, and others, your calls are straight ahead. I'm just going to take nothing but calls the rest of the hour. Then I've got Russia moving its nuke missiles in to the edge of Europe, threatening to nuke. I've got all the other economic news.
Have you ever lost your power and wanted to simply...
Friends, thank you so much for joining us again today here in the InfoWar. Let's go to your phone calls. Bill in Michigan, you're on the air, sir. Welcome.
Alex Jones. You there, sir?
Yep. All right. Well, go ahead, sir.
Oh, hey. I've been listening regularly for several months, but in case I missed it, did you or anybody on your show yet raise the possibility they got mind control over all my sheep by means of making us think they're big? Because relative to like 100 million fighting age American patriots, there's really only a few of them. So
no, no, that's right. That's right. That's right. Using divide and conquer, there's only a few thousand globalist tops. They run only a few staged events, and then the media plays along with it, though they're not even really part of it. And then they're able to make us, the true liberty movement that's the majority, feel like we're the minority. That is the essence of mind control.
Yeah, we get all this media showing us, you know, the tyranny, the forms of tyranny, the military arming of police forces, but how many people went and really checked to see, you know, how big they are yet? I think all this media hype about all this stuff that they do is to make people think they're bigger than they really are. There's more of them than they really are, including the, you know, the ones who are doing the pat downs and grinning and loving this.
I hear you, man. I appreciate your call. Good points. James in New York. James, you're on the air. Go ahead. All right, James. Well, I guess you don't want to talk either. Thank you for the call. Let's talk to Greg in North Carolina. You're on the air, Greg. Go ahead. All right, Greg, don't want to talk either. He's listening to his radio. No, no, we're gone. We're gone. Let's talk to Colt in Arkansas or Kansas or wherever he's calling from. Go ahead, Colt. You're on the air.
Hi. How's it going?
Good, sir. Broadcasting worldwide. May I help you?
I was just wanting to say, you know, I've been listening to you for a few years now, but my nephew was living in Virginia, and, you know, he was working at one of the gas stations there. And he actually got fired from his job because he told a girl that he wanted to legally obtain a gun and, concealed carry permit. And they said that that was a violence against
absolutely,
the job.
Absolutely, fired. Absolutely, absolutely. Look, if you play video games and talk about them, they kick you out of school. If you have a Nerf gun in your backyard, you're kicked out of school. There's no law. They just do it. They are creating the perception that, oh, you drew a Christmas card at school that showed a Christmas tree, it's banned because it violates church and state. The school can't have an official religion, but in your speech as valedictorian or in your Christmas cards you hand out, you can do whatever you want under the First Amendment. And again, this is authoritarianism in America. People don't know their rights, so they're being run all over. Yes, this is the fiat by fiat, outside of law, eradication of all of our rights, not just the Second Amendment. They're going after all of them.
They did more than fire him. The cops ended up picking him up and forcing him to go to a psychiatric evaluation for up to two, or I think
exactly. And then let me guess, they claimed he was mentally ill and he can't own guns anymore.
Yeah, they removed his right in Virginia to own guns, so he now moved to Kansas, so that way they had more lax laws on the guns.
And that was because he didn't know his rights. He should have laughed when they got there, said, what are you talking about? I only said I want to get a concealed carry to protect myself, you know, if we work at a convenience store. You guys are acting like I've done something wrong. Okay, go ahead and charge me. But he got intimidated and went, all right, All right, I'll go to the testing, you say, and then they go to their operative that then declares they have no rights. See how that's all rigged, and then they extrajudicially remove your rights through organized crime, racketeering, fraud. These are criminal institutions. And again, the police themselves don't even like what's going on, but they follow the orders or they lose their job. Hey, cops, you're going to lose everything anyways under this. But you notice I knew the rest of the story because this is a shake and bake operation. And the minute you tell the cops you know your rights, but actually know them and go, just because she was upset that I said I had a Second Amendment and planned to get a concealed carry, I'm sorry, she's a weirdo and been so conditioned to hate somebody talking about public rights. I guess it's their policy not to talk about that. I can see why they fired me. I think it was wrongful termination, and the courts would probably agree with me. But, you know, no, you're not going to take me to jail. And if they take you to jail, you go, okay, I'm not going to resist. I'm just going to sue everybody here for official oppression. And you go before the jury, and you call her in. What did I say? I'm going to get a concealed carry. He said it. I'm scared. Well, that's concealed carry is the law in this state, jury. Was I falsely imprisoned? They release you. You're found not guilty. Now you've got the tort, the major lawsuit. Boom. But see, the people perish for lack of knowledge. I see articles every day where an old man's cleaning their gun in the country. The police come, take their guns, put them in jail, and then take their right to own guns because a neighbor saw guns that were legal and didn't like them.
We're on the march.
Sometimes the news gets me really, really angry. I also keep forgetting, guys, that AC is off right there and it's boiling in here. I just psychoanalyzed the reason I'm getting so angry on and off air is that AC was turned off. Will someone turn it on right now? Actually, I'll do it. Watch this. Boom! All right, got it done. Got it done, baby. AC back on. Yeah! Yeah! I turned that AC on! Anyways, I sit here and I see all this New World Order stuff. I can feel it. I see all the stuff they're doing to us, and I got to be honest with you. I start getting really, really angry. I'm in a very bad mood right now. And so when I go to callers and caller after caller has their radio on in the background, I kind of get a little bit angry, and I apologize. I want to take your calls, and I want to have the radio turned up all the way with like a 15-second delay, however you're listening, or 10-second delay, and that's how we're going to broadcast. We will just broadcast me talking with a delay and with you talking over it while you listen to yourself. Anyways, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining us on this live worldwide edition of the Alex Jones Show, and that's me, and we are here, and I am very happy and blessed and pleased to be here with you today. And I am very, very thankful for all the listeners and all the liberty lovers out there. I salute you all. Thank you all for helping us collectively defend ourselves from the collectivists, because we are individuals, but we must come together collectively to organize and oppose this tyranny. And here's what I'm going to do. 800-259-9231. I am going to take a ton of phone calls and break the spell of the fact that I am a horrible talk show host when it comes to taking phone calls. And there's a big debate on whether I should even take calls or whether I should take more calls. I like calls. I like the news you bring up. I like the different angles you take us to. But randomly, some of the callers sound like, because it's during the weekday, you know, and they're home or whatever on the day off, and they're drinking, you know, a bottle of Wild Turkey or something, or Old Crow. And so you are barred from calling in if you've had more than half a gallon of whiskey. Only allowed to have one half a gallon before you call in on the show. 800-259-9231. I'm going to give each caller a minute. I'll give myself a 10-second response. Oh, yeah, is this the video of the Santas beating each other up? Absolutely. This will get everybody in the mood, is the Santas beating each other up. Yeah, I saw that on Drudge. This country is a complete insane asylum. And I think I'm a good representation of it all as well. Oh, my goodness. Oh, boy. It's absolutely out of control. If you didn't know, the video is up on drudgereport.com. That's the kind of video we need on Infowars.com, is the Santas. In fact, I said I'd go to your calls, but I'm just too intrigued by the Santas beating each other's up in New York City. It's from Breitbart. Video Santa's brawl near Union Square. A group of men believed to be participating in a Santa Con was captured on video throwing blows on the corner of the 17th Street and 3rd Avenue in Manhattan Saturday night. The Daily News notified cops of the video posted on YouTube. NYPD spokesman. I wonder if it's a hoax, folks. Let me see that video again. Let me see if that looks like it's real to me. If you're watching on Infowars.com/show, you can see this. I don't know. It kind of looks real, but they might be good actors. The way they're walking away and everything, the way this is taking place. I don't know. It looks like it might be real to me. Unbelievably ridiculous. All right, let's go to your phone calls. Hey, the Russians moving nuclear weapons up against Europe, strategic weapons, trogs, basically. That's not a big issue, threatening to nuke Europe. The Santa Clauses, ladies and gentlemen. Bad Santas is what I guess you'd call them. Okay, let's go to your calls. Jim in Washington, D.C. Thanks for calling in, brother. Good to have you on board today.
How's it going?
Good. Good, sir. Thank you.
I just want to make you aware that it doesn't matter about my situation, but I was just informed that the FBI now is not wasting any funds or investigating crimes under $100,000, even though they're the only ones that have jurisdiction.
No, I know. If it's a federal crime, the local police tell you no, and then the FBI tells you no. And that basically is part of the lawlessness of society. And imagine living in New York, Chicago, or D.C. where you can't have guns to protect yourself, and then criminals are allowed to run absolutely wild. But if you even tell an officer you don't think you were driving the speed they said, they will taser you or shoot you or worse. Like in San Antonio, the guy said, I wasn't speeding, and the cop pulled a clip out in front of everyone, pulled a gun out, and emptied the entire magazine directly into him. So it's death penalty for not groveling to government. Everything else is legal now.
Yeah, I mean, it's ridiculous. And then I called three different FBI bureaus. They all told me the same thing. And seven different agents told me the same thing. And one of the agents said he would see if he could bend the rules and get someone to investigate it. And it's not a lot of money. It's a lot of money to me. It was $33,000, but... to this day, the FBI refuses to investigate, even though...
Well, people better be wise about what they're doing, because the general public doesn't know how to make money by working or producing. It's swindling, it's scams, it's incredible. God bless you. I appreciate your call. I've got to do a whole show on this, on scams they use with musicians just in Austin, but I know it's all over the country, where they have these lawyers and these record companies that never put anything out. Or have like one person they claim that got a record deal or something. And then a record deal itself is always a scam now, the way it's set up, to where you could sell $5 million worth of stuff. You're going to get like $30,000 if you're lucky. And they literally have all these musicians that go and spend like $20,000, $30,000 making a record or making a single. And it's all just a scam with lawyers in the back room laughing at everyone. And it doesn't matter. The people don't want to admit they've been scammed or conned, and they just keep doing it over and over again. Things are so gamed now in Hollywood and in music that even big stars a lot of the time don't even make money. I mean, it's all rigged, ladies and gentlemen. Believe me, I know. And it just shows how, and it's the gullibility of everybody is what's allowing this. Look at Obamacare. His idiot supporters actually believe it's all an accident. Let's talk to Greg in North Carolina. Greg, thanks for calling in, sir.
Thanks, Alex. How you doing?
Pretty good, brother. Good to be talking to you.
Good to talk to you, first-time caller. Are you familiar with a program started back in the 50s and supposedly was halted, but I know that it's not, called Project MK Ultra, where they were using LSD to CIA to brainwash people and to... try to have them to do their bidding, sort of similar to what they're doing today.
Yes, sir. And they killed Captain Olson, throwing him out the window. And MK Ultra came out in the 70s. It had gone on in the 50s, 60s, and 70s. MK, Naomi, there's a bunch of other ones. And those programs all continue on today publicly in the U.S. Army, mainly. They openly drug and brainwash the troops now, calling it therapy. And then they have Air Force colonels and people, you know, who literally are over the mass shooters. publicly, and it all comes out, no one gets in trouble. And the Boston Globe is reporting that the known CIA asset, Tamerlan Tsarnaev, was saying he was under MKUltra, one of the monarch-type programs is what he said.
Correct.
In that, don't you think if they do that, we should give our rights up? I mean, all right, go ahead.
I'm not giving mine up.
But the government will be much nicer to us if we just lay down.
Well, I don't know if you remember or not. I'm the one that contacted you last year in April because I had posted some things on a Facebook account. The Secret Service came and arrested me. I was afraid I was going to disappear, but it all came out okay.
I remember that. You know, there's a lot of talk show hosts we've had on who mildly criticized the Lord and Savior, Barack Obama, as Jamie Foxx calls him, not me. And they come and arrest you, put you in a psychiatric ward, take your guns. And so that's how they're persecuting us, the same way Nazi Germany started out using psychiatrists in the Soviet Union as well. God bless you, Greg. Good to hear from you. Have a great Christmas coming up. Cobalt in Canada in the Great White North. You're on the air, Cobalt.
How are you doing, Alex?
I'm doing good, brother. Good to talk to you. How may I serve you today?
I'm drinking a little tangy tangerine. The new stuff's fantastic.
Well, thank you, brother. What do you make of all the news we covered?
Well, I'm calling regarding the Colorado shooting and the brainwashing part of it. He was going after the members of the conservative debate team. So I'm thinking, since Oprah said that all these racist conservatives had to die, he probably took it upon himself from her command to go out and do this.
You know, that's a good point. That should be the headline. Was Colorado shooter following Oprah's command? Because
well,
it is true.
I would say that.
Absolutely. She wouldn't even need a connection. I mean, she says, I'm deeply racist and behind the Boston bombing with no proof. But
I think she should look at the other angle. There was Oprah.
Well, Oprah actually said, if you disagree with Obama, you're racist, and people that are racist need to just die. But she won't be getting her bodyguards or guns taken anytime soon. But for those that don't know, fill them in on why you're saying that. I mean, give us your take. It's come out that the shooter was on the debate team and disagreed with people on the debate team. That's in the local news. The sheriffs say that. So he came with a shotgun to try to kill the debate coach, a librarian, and people on the debate team. Now, who would have, quote, we have the video, very proud of being a socialist, and the paper confirmed that he was listed on the debate team as a proud socialist. Who would a socialist be coming to kill on the debate team?
Well, that's the whole thing, is that, Obama, if you're against him anyway, well, you're a racist and you have to die. So I'm assuming that this was his angle. Oprah told him, you know what, these conservatives got to go.
Oh, no, we went and looked up the debate team's names and stuff, and they are conservatives and libertarians, and they, you know, one of them did get shot and is alive still. And I know that probably makes the Common Core folks angry. But, you know, I mean, he's a socialist. He wanted to kill people on the debate team. A 2 + 2 = he wanted to kill libertarians or conservatives or free market people. But now under Common Core, 2 + 2 = 5. And if you don't agree with that, you're, well, racist. So, Cobalt, do you want to say you're sorry for being racist?
Well, not today. I think I'll just enjoy some tangy tangerine. It seems to keep me focused and away from the socialist side of things.
All right. God bless you, extremist.
Thank you, sir.
Oh, boy, that was really a sicko calling in, folks. I apologize for that racism. Let's talk to Tim in North Carolina. You're on the air, Tim.
Hey, Alex. I want to say thanks for doing what you're doing. I always said, as long as you're on the air, we have some semblance of a First Amendment.
Some semblance of insanity, the good type, yeah.
I was wondering if you caught, it's about a couple months old now, but Elizabeth Woodworth's article about search engine manipulation, specifically in regards to the Truth Seeker episode on RT about 9/11.
Yes, if you don't have Google AdSense or other systems on your computer or on your website, they automatically don't list you as high. There's been lawsuits over that. But also some of the other big search engine groups and advertising groups do that as well. And there's all sorts of search engine manipulation of different news stories, different items. It's just fraught with it. But even despite that, dinosaur media is flailing around in its death throes, and real media is seeing a huge rebirth. But give us your take on it.
Yeah, I mean, I was thinking they changed the date on the episode on RT so that it looked like it was not from September 11th of this year, but from 2011. So it put it in another spot on their website so that people couldn't find it in the search engines. But I also wanted to ask what you make of Representative Stephen Lynch trying to get the redacted 28 pages from the 9/11 report declassified.
I think that's really essential. We know they lied about what really happened on 9/11. We know they did know about the supposed attacks that were going to be coming. And I support transparency. I mean, the government has used all this secrecy to allow special interests to come in and build an empire of fraud. And then they tell us, like the former NSA director did on, I think it was Meet the Press yesterday. I saw a clip of it. He was going, trust us, be adult. Let us spy on you. So they've gone from, we promise we're not spying on you, to we're spying on you for your own safety.
Yeah, I guess it's a matter of, like, what will actually work. You know, are these folks that are in Congress actually awake to this? Or is this, you know, is this part of a show? You know, what power do they have if they can get this stuff declassified? You know, I mean, this in my opinion, this event seems like the magic bullet to all this mind control stuff.
No, you're right. But I mean, look, we have to get behind members of Congress that tell the truth and stand up for what's right. And when they get attacked with a bunch of fake dirt, we've got to stand behind them, because the system does gang up and go after people that tell the truth. But see, we've hit the tipping point where the system's so discredited, attacking us with lies doesn't work anymore. It becomes a red badge of honor or red badge of courage when the system attacks us. So we need to back people in the Republican Party, Libertarian Party, Constitution Party, Democratic Party, if they stand up for transparency and what's right. And even if we disagree with somebody part of the time, when they do the right thing, we need to support what they're doing. God bless you. I appreciate your call. Great questions. Good caller. He was not drinking a gallon of corn syrup or cough syrup. Let's talk to Faith in California. Thank you for calling in.
Yeah, hi, Alex. Thank you for everything you're doing. You're waking a lot of people up.
Well, thank you, ma'am. We're trying. What's on your mind?
Well, I'm just looking at everything on a whole, the big picture, and I'm saying, you know, this is all gone lawless. It's out of control. And if I look back, our forefathers would be collectively meeting right now in secret on how to overthrow this thing.
That would be terrorist.
Yeah, I know, I am. Okay, well, anyway, yeah, old lady, 5'2", right, 105 pounds. Anyway, this is a war against us, right? Agreed?
Absolutely.
It's a mind war, though. This is not a physical war. It's a mind war. Well, you know, a mind war is going to come down to a physical war eventually at some point. And all I'm here to say is I think we need more offensive strategies. We have great defensive strategies. You brought that up. But in any game, war game, or a football stadium, gladiatorial game, Spartans, you name it, they always had good offensive strategies.
Well, listen, I'm only one person. I'm going to come back to you after the break. I'm going to put you on hold. We're going to break. I'm going to come back to Faith from California, a great caller. I agree. In fact, I should throw that out to ask the callers who are calling in on other issues. How do we get on the offense? I mean, I went to Dallas to stand up for the First Amendment to point out they were trying to ban free speech in the city. They backed off about 75%.
Yeah.
I'm one person. So
I know.
So we're going to come back to you. We're going to put her on hold now. We're going to put Faith on hold. And then we're going to come back, and I'm going to talk to her some more after the break. Now, we need to talk about how do we get on the offense, because people always call in telling me how I can get on the offense. And I can try harder. But I'm working pretty hard here. We need all of you to get on the offense in lots of little ways. That's what's going to bring them down. Let's talk about it when we come back. Coming up, I'm going to break down MIT's 3D motion tracking tech that can see you through walls, no camera needed. They've had this, in quote, law enforcement, militarized federal police state for 20 years, mounted on helicopters, looking through your walls. Now they're just announcing it to all the slaves. The slaves pay to put the Kinect box in their house and be surveilled by DARPA, by the NSA, and then all the sickos over there that run it get up on TV and lecture you how it's for your own safety. We're going to go back to the caller. Which caller was that I was talking to? Is she still on hold? Who was that I was talking to? Yeah, it was Faith. We're going to go back to Faith here in just a moment. But briefly here, ladies and gentlemen, We have some really amazing products available at InfoWarsLife.com. We have the best-selling Survival Shield proprietary nascent iodine that does so much to protect your thyroid from different forms of isotopes and radiation. And so many people have iodine deficiencies. This is the unbound iodine that goes right into the bloodstream and right into the organs. Consult your physician before taking it. It's done wondrous things for myself and my family in detoxification, you name it. You can get it now with the fluoride shield that also has nascent iodine, but five other compounds with it. That's a 2-ounce bottle, by the way. It shows it is the same size here in the image, but it's actually twice the size. You can get it, both of them, for $49.95. Your savings is $59.95. And, of course, that's off the regular savings, where normally Survival Shield is $30, fluoride shield is $40, but we've taken $10 off the fluoride shield, so that's 25% off fluoride shield when you get it with Survival Shield and stock up. A 48-hour sale, and your purchase also supports the transmission. And believe me, folks, we only promote and sell things that have had a dynamite effect personally with myself, like the Patriot Blend, Arabica from southern Mexico, shade grown by the Chiapas farmers, totally organic, Oregon tilt level, beyond fair trade. It's available at InfoWarsLife.com as well. It's what I love. You've heard the rave reviews. I don't sell junk. So that's all available at InfoWarsLife.com. 48-hour sale, 25% off fluoride shield. We're running that until Wednesday morning. 48-hour sale available at InfoWarsLife.com. Let's go back to Faith. Okay, Faith, how do we get on the offense? Faith from California, best call of the day. I agree with you. I mean, InfoWar is offensive. We're defensively fighting them while exposing the real agenda. That's really the offense. We're trying to get states' rights going. We're trying to defend the family. We're trying to get healthy. We're trying to speak to those in the power structure that are compartmentalized, to decompartmentalize them so they know they're part of something really evil. What do we do? What are your ideas?
Okay, I totally agree. We got a good defense already, and you're fighting that. And my idea is that we got to go back to the Revolutionary War and our forefathers who fought for our country. They were under mind control, too. They had to get away from England, and they knew they were going to fight England. We were just farmers. We were just regular people. And those British had those fancy uniforms and everything on, and they thought they were going to come in, and they were just going to take over. Well, they had another thing coming. And I just think we need, as patriots, to collectively get together and talk in war rooms or in homes where there is no TV on. There is no...
No, I hear you. You should be knocking on neighbors' doors. You should be going to city council. You should be organizing your own true liberty tea parties in your area and really pointing out this country's been captured. And that's it. But listen, everybody's looking for a silver bullet. Like it's going to happen overnight. It's a process. And we're actually getting momentum now and pushing back and having success. So I think the most important thing is to realize we're in the fight. Things will only be better if we stand up. Third hour coming up. Folks, I'm going to continue with your phone calls, and then I've got to get into all the economic police state news, Russia news that we've not covered yet here today. Right now, let's go to Bob in Maine. Bob, thanks for calling. Thanks for holding. How may I serve you today?
Hey, what's going on, Alex?
Worldwide broadcast. We're just on the air, broadcasting worldwide. What's going on with you?
Sounds good. I had an idea for you. You want to know about going on the offensive. Two things that I had thought of was one of them is trying to lower your tax footprint. Not talking about anything illegal, but trying to do things to support the system even less. And if everyone does that,
well, listen, I mean, at a certain point, I pay all the fraudulent taxes because I'm a big target and I choose my battles. But there are 60 million Americans, they estimate, not paying the fake income tax. That's un-American. The Federal Reserve set it up in 1913. It's meant to destroy and debase the country. Not $1 of it goes to run the nation. And the more people do not pay or comply, that's how we bring them down. I mean, it's real simple. We don't pay any of it anymore. It's all meant to destitute us. It's all meant to destroy us. It's all meant to bankrupt us. They are the enemy. Go ahead. Sorry.
And then the other thing, too, is we shut off our Time Warner cable TV. I'm like, why am I paying to subsidize corporate whore media? I just stuck an antenna up on the roof of my house. If I can't pick it up on the 10 channels I pick up an antenna, I just go read a book.
Exactly. I mean, God bless you. That's such genius. Absolutely. Decouple from their system. Vote with your dollars with people that tell the truth. It's the same thing with organic food.
That's why 1,000 cuts is what it is.
Yes.
If enough people just say, you know what, why am I paying for Al Sharpton, you know, and all these other blowhards, just turn it off. And I do have a question for you, too.
Yes, sir.
You had mentioned maybe about a year or two ago, briefly, something about a free-to-air television. Were you having any plans of bringing your TV news broadcast to a free-to-air TV? Are you familiar
with
that?
Yes, yes. Here's the issue. I've never been a manager. And so I'm busy realizing how to manage now that I've got to create absolute formulaic systems on everything. Because I got a great crew and it's getting better every day, but I run around literally saying we need to order more toilet paper. So I've got to get to a point where that's not going on so I can get our TV news up and running at the level it needs to be, which is close, while we're busy, you know, it's like a cartoon. You got 1,000 plates in your hand and more plates are getting added. I'm getting folks where they're taking plates from me. We're creating a standardized, coordinated system. It's hard to do this. And yes, we're going to put it up in the next month or so on these systems. And then I've got to decide what free-to-air systems to pay for, what's best. I'm talking to consultants. I'm looking at it. Obviously, they don't just let you on everything when you've got this message. A lot of it I'm thinking will be, hey, we're about to go free-to-air or we're about to go on these satellites. We need you to contact these people and get us on there. But all that's got to be planned right out, you know, with an actual plan.
Yeah, I actually have a free-to-air system, so I use it and I tune my satellite dish and I pick up all kinds of stuff from all over the world, so it'd be something I'd be very interested in just because I am an InfoWars subscriber, but also to have the access to the free-to-air, you know, broadcast, that'd be great.
Yeah, no, my plan that I've said publicly for like 7 years, but I'm always trying to get the capital and running everything else, is to build what Glenn Beck then took, borrowed from us and built, which is fine. And he also got it from some other people as well. But that's clearly the direction the media has been going forever. And we've built part of that. We just don't have hundreds of millions of dollars. We have millions of dollars. And we are getting out on more and more platforms. But I'm a bad manager at many levels. I need to get it where I can just coordinate people how they post stuff to YouTube. You know, I can't even do that. So, you know, I'm doing the best I can. But, yes, sir, we're going to have free-to-air. I've got to choose which satellites are the best. And then I'm going to try to get on some of the other, you know, Dish Network, DirecTV, things like that. But it takes money. It takes energy. It takes organization. And we're almost there to be able to do that. But it's playing in the big time, not pretending. Folks, we're back live here now into the third hour. I'm going to go back to your phone calls. But let me hit some of the other news we haven't really gotten to yet. Some of this is some really good news. Some of it's some really bad news. Boston police halt license plate scanning program after the Boston Globe pointed out that it was being used to track and trace where everyone went, basically going into NSA-style databases. I was first telling people 16, 17 years ago about license plate scanners that were already up nationwide by the feds, and people didn't even believe it, even when it was admitted. Just like the black boxes in your cars that track everywhere you go. And now they want to tax you by the mile, so they're telling you, hey, there's a box in your car. And again, I'm not saying, oh, I'm so smart, look how I warned you, look how I told you. It's very frustrating that on all the other stuff we tell you that's on record, like your Xbox hooked into the NSA looking through your walls, that this is really going on. This is really happening. The FBI without warrants is really listening to the microphones in your computer because they have unlimited computing power with your tax money. And so why not listen to what everything you're doing? Why not dial in to the cameras? I mean, this is 50 light years past 1984, and it was in place on 9/11, and it didn't stop the attacks of 9/11. Of course it didn't stop them, because the people that have hijacked the government are the ones that did it. It's that simple. And I'm not trying to be negative here, folks. You have to admit how much trouble we're in if we have a snowball's chance in hell of ever turning this around. And it's some days I come in here and the news makes me so upset that I actually, it's not like even a headache, it's like a grump ache. like where I physically am angry in my mind, where it's not even like a headache. It's like a burning anger. You know what the feeling, like I could really kick somebody's butt right now. You know that feeling. And it's because as a primitive person, who, and I have my intellectual areas, but also have my primitive areas, I am just absolutely fire-breathing angry at the establishment. I don't even hate them. It's disgusting what the degenerate control freak filth they are and how they got control of our society and siphon off trillions of dollars and all of our different ingenuity to build monstrosities when they should be having all the different clean energy, free energy deployments. There should be giant space colonies already, life extension for everybody, not putting up with people being lazy, promoting individual liberty, using role models to uplift humanity. I mean, just incredible potential. The potential. Instead, all we're doing is learning how to worship a bunch of big, fat, ugly rap stars and football and just all of it. Miley Cyrus and all of it. And it's not that, oh, I'm shocked by her licking things. And it's just so stupid. It's all crafted, and then they make that our culture. That's humanity. A bunch of crazy narcissist drug addicts. You look in their eyes, they're a bunch of vapid trash. I hate them. Ugh. And it's beyond hatred. It's just absolute disgust. Absolute disgust at all of it. I mean, teaching kids, the whole government should be absolutely removed for the federal government officially teaching 2 + 2 equals 5. And if I've got to explain to people how that is a crime against humanity, then we're done. This is the outrageous, savage brainwashing evil, the willful desire to hurt the young and to screw them up by these sicko globalists who really are degenerates and who really are mentally ill and like to dumb people down and poison the water and poison the food and jack with everything. So they can play God and feel like they're smarter than everyone. Imagine wanting to brain damage 7 billion people so you, some degenerate, inbred, New World Order piece of trash who's got all your own mental illnesses can get off on the power trip of what you're doing. You people are absolute criminals against humanity. And I just absolutely see you. You are like giant rotten bags of vomit spewed out of the most scrofulous, disgusting corner of the universe. You people are the most low-down, pathetic, rat-like, cowardly scum I could imagine. I can't even probably do the show right now, folks. I'm not kidding around, okay? I am sick and tired of it. Excuse me. I start thinking about how criminal and how organized and how premeditated all this is and how and all the horrible things they're doing to us. It should just end overnight. It should just absolutely end a lot quicker. Look at this right here. And it's the laziness and the lethargy of people in this society and the infighting and the baseness of the general population that has allowed this to take place, has allowed the fall of humanity, who has allowed this garbage to unfold. Oh, the cowards, all the toadies, all the little social engineers and their little crews who think they're smart because they know how to manipulate people. Pieces of trash. Anyways, let's get back to this news here. Boston police halt license scanning program. Look at this one. I see this all the time. Remember the kid in Colorado who was kissing girls in the first grade because he liked them? And it turned out the girls liked it as well. And it was just normal, free puppy love behavior. It's totally natural, totally normal, totally healthy. And then the parents fought back and didn't agree to him being listed as a sex offender. So they had to remove that because the parents stood up and knew it was total mind control and rebuked it and used the enemy's outrageous social engineering against him. You know, they teach in all major colleges now that all sex between a man and a woman is rape of the woman. Again, this is 2 + 2 = 5, scientific gang raping of your mind. That's the raping that's going on here. Look at this. Italian protester kiss with sexual violence. Good-looking woman kisses the visor of the cops that are attacking him. The Italian police have been joining the protesters. And this woman, you can see the body language, clearly tried to project love at the police and solidarity. They have arrested her and are moving forward to charge her with rape, sexual violence. When women have handed flowers to police worldwide, they beat them. Or if you blow bubbles saying love and one floats and hits a guy in the eye, he goes, oh my gosh, he doesn't call it bubbles. He goes, detergent, I've been hit, and rolls around. There's that video. Search a cop hit by bubble yells detergent. It's all part of the petty act. But if they taser you, it's just pain compliance, just torture. Look at how they operate. Look at what they do. Look at how they push this on society. A woman kisses the plastic visor. Oh, when the cops punch you or ram into you, they're just doing their job. But when you, I guess actually that is a man and a woman trying to kiss, so I guess that is offensive. They're banned the name mother and father in France and now in the U.S. from documents because it's hurtful to others. I guess it is hate speech, actually. It's a woman showing sexual desire for a man. I don't know. This is pretty darn evil. Yeah, here he is. Let's turn it up. We have the audio where he says the bubbles.
It's a deliberate act on your behalf. I'm going to arrest you. Do you understand me?
Do you understand me?
You're going to be in handcuffs. All right? You either knock it off with the bubble, you touch me with that bubble, you're going into custody. Right?
I'm putting it away.
Right, thank you.
But I would also like to know...
Look how there's no respect. Here, stop right there. There he is pushing the camera back. No respect for us. Just an arrogance. You belong to us. We own you. I want to arrest you. I want to be a predator. I want to take you down. It's a total culture of anything you do. We're going to twist the law to put you in jail. But the government commits every crime, every criminal action, every evil, putting poison in the water supply on record, picked up by the Soviets and the Nazis to brain damage us. They are murdering people. They are poisoning us. Bone cancer, IQ reduction, stomach cancer, kidney failure from fluoride. They're murdering us. And you go talk to city council, they act all imperious and laugh. And if they don't like what you say, the cops drag you out. This has happened over and over again. Let me tell you something, cop, that was telling that woman that with the bubbles that are a foot away from him. Let me tell you something. You get that detergent in my eye, I'm going to arrest you. It's such and such. I don't even know we played the first part where he says that. But the point is that you've only been given unnatural authority under tyranny. You've been put and chosen for your arrogant, imperious nature because great evil is coming, and you're a vanguard meant to lower the drawbridge for the orcs to come in. And when smog of the New World Order arrives and burns your world to the ground, remember you begged for it. Yeah, start it from the beginning with her with the bubbles.
It makes people smile. My name is a mystery.
Oh. Power trip. The cops are on.
If the bubble touches me, I'm going to be arrested for assault. Do you understand me?
Bubbles.
Yes, that's right. It's a deliberate act on your behalf. I'm going to arrest you.
No, that's not it, guys. There's another video where a bubble goes by and the cop starts crying, going, detergent, detergent. Look, here's the deal. They've built FEMA camps. They call them Emergency Centers Establishment Act. They call them the Civilian Inmate Labor Camp Program. And they say in the Army Manual, you will be processed by Social Security number, broken up from your family, and sent for re-education. Where pit demon goblins are going to be waiting who literally love total evil, who've been selectively, psychologically profiled for pit demon activity. And you need to understand, you are now being handed over to Satan. So I'm going to come back and take phone calls. I didn't get to all the other articles. Journalists rip apart 60 Minutes for embarrassing and uncritical NSA report. Yeah, total disgusting worship of the NSA spying on you. They've gone from saying none of it's happening to, it's all for your own good. We got some healthcare news. VA lobotomized 2,000 disturbed veterans. Oh, yeah, you have a little bit of PTSD? We're going to take a scalpel and we're going to cut out the front of your brain. How's that sound? Doesn't matter, they got vaccines coming out, they're going to do it anyways. And soon, none of you will even be able to complain. Soon, they're going to release the brain-eating vaccines, and everyone will get what they want. I am your host, Alex Jones, and we're taking your phone calls. Bunch of news we haven't hit yet coming up in the next segment. But right now, let's go back to your phone calls. Let's go ahead and talk to James in Kentucky. James, you're on the air. Welcome.
Hey, how you doing?
Brother, I'm doing great.
Thank
Thanks for asking. Everybody asks me how I'm doing, and then the next caller asks me how I'm doing, and then the next caller asks me how I'm doing. Let me ask you this. How are you doing?
Not real good. Sorry, I know sometimes people have themselves on speaker fence and they have to wait a long time, and then finally they get on.
Well, I'm doing pretty good today. Most of the callers have been holding about 20 minutes.
Thank you, sir. I just want to ask you, what do you know about the serial number that's on our birth certificate that supposedly establishes us as collateral to our debt?
They claim that number is just to mark which group of prints that was to establish it's not a counterfeit. But the Social Security number itself does establish you in the IMF and World Bank as a human resource, as collateral. So that is true.
Oh, okay. Thank you very much. That's also what I was wondering.
No, but seriously, I mean, if you have another question.
How do they keep getting away with killing everybody? You know, all of our, you know, movie stars and everything. I mean, you know, and, like, I've seen a list of Clinton, like, all the people he's had knocked off, you know, and it's just disgusting. You know, I feel exactly the same as you do.
Yeah, I mean, I know why people tune out of it and just give up and kind of roll over and let the globalists do whatever they want, because deep down you go, what do I do about this? I think it's a balance, though. Most people don't do anything about it. All I do is do this 24/7. And, I mean, sometimes it just really freaks me out to just see how unaware people are of how much peril we're collectively in.
Like, I mean, like I seen online, Mark Dice, you know, completely, you know, rejecting the idea that Paul Walker was knocked off, you know. I mean, I've seen, like, Bruce Lee, Brandon Lee, Heath Ledger, you know. I mean, is that...
Well, it is true they kill a lot of... there are a lot of managers in Hollywood that clearly kill people under them so they get to keep their estate that they're managing. That's why nobody in Hollywood should have some manager that's in control of their estate, because then that gives them the... that gives them the incentive to knock you off. I don't think that Walker was probably knocked off. There were enough witnesses to see what happened. I even got blamed for saying that a drone did it when we said the opposite. But I don't think you can be criticized for looking at that when there's such a history of it going on. I hear what you're saying. I appreciate your call. Interesting call there. All right, Bruce in Tennessee. How are you doing, Bruce?
Well, Alex, I'm a little bit freaked out like you are. I'm watching the police state accelerate at dramatic rates, and I'm seeing in this little sleepy area of Memphis an enormous amount of activity from the police. Literally in the last year, the police, I see them on a daily 15-minute, 30-minute basis.
I know. They are massively increasing the number of government enforcers because they're getting ready to absolutely gut the country.
Well, I actually decided to try to take some action against it, Alex. I actually put out a little community newsletter citing an enormous amount of facts based upon the local level. For example, that Shelby County sheriffs currently use shock handcuffs. In their, if they detain you, they decide, you know, whether or not they can use that. As an example, they also have gotten drones here. I see drones here fly over almost every other day. It's starting to increase, actually, to almost every 12 hours sometimes.
No, I know. And that's Homeland Security doing that. When they're done, everyone in an airport will wear a shock bracelet because we're all criminals except the state. And again, Popular Science reports on it. These terrifying handcuffs can shock and drug prisoners. And again, all of our money is spent by the parasitic government to keep the animals or their food, that's us, in place. And so, yes, now when the police pull you over, they'll put you in stun cuffs. And then any excuse, any arguing, anything, they're going to tase you. And then the other psychopaths that run the department will then say, oh, we agree with what you did, until it will be just killing you for disagreeing with them, which they now do in San Antonio.
Exactly. And actually, I have relatives in San Antonio whom I went there, and I got into a physical altercation with the San Antonio PD, unfortunately. And no charges, et cetera, right? But basically, back here in Memphis, let me tell you something. They got really pissed off about the newsletter that I wrote and handed out into the people's mailboxes myself manually about the police abuse in the local area. And
you mean you as an American handed out material political? You don't do that in America. What do you think this is, a free country?
Oh, man, you know what they did? Just not even about a week ago, they claimed that a robber... You can look it up. There was a video. It was really weird.
They claimed there was a robber, so they had to come in your house without a warrant.
No, not my house. They blocked off the whole street and started IDing everybody before they would even let them in.
Yeah, that's a martial law capture drill. You train the victim. They do this with child molestation, that you touch them first a bunch and control them until you've tested them. And that's the same thing. The criminals are now testing the control of the slaves in the public schools, on the highways. It's all prisoner capture training. So when they really finally kidnap you, it's all over and you don't resist.
We're on the march.
Let me cover a little bit more of the news here in the stacks, and then I will go back to your phone calls, JD and Chad and many others that are patiently holding. The toll-free number to join us is 800-259-9231. Yeah, there's no mistake that the police under federal grants nationwide are running illegal checkpoints, control and cordon checkpoints, just familiarizing the public with contact with the police. Because in a free country, the police only respond to crime and emergencies. They don't ask people questions and set up checkpoints and set up citizen spy groups and have the general public accustomed to contact with the police and other agencies. And this is all part of the admitted acclimation and the total rollout of the end of America as we know it. And, I figured out one reason I get so mad some days, and this is one of them, is that I just realize it's so real. I've been so right, and it's disgusting. And that's why when callers call in, such sweet, good people, and say, thank you, Alex. Thank you? I mean, I'm watching the country burn down, folks, and you're thanking me, and I don't mind it. It's just that I always get, thank you. What you up to? Well, I'm on a radio show. Please don't thank me. Because I don't feel like I'm doing that good of a job. I'm freaked out. You're trying to find the lever to move the world. I'm trying to find the lever to move the world. And so I'm taking a lot of calls, and I'm really enjoying it and talking to you. Callers are bringing up a lot of great questions. It's just that if I sound irritable some days, it's because, man, I know how real this is. It's all out in the open. And it's really freaking me out. It's really, 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 really freaking me out. The U.S. government lobotomized 2,000 mentally ill veterans and likely hundreds more during and after World War II, according to a cache of forgotten memos, letters, and government reports unearthed by the Wall Street Journal. That's in the Army Times. That's nothing compared to what's currently going on. New AP poll, nearly 4 in 5 say Obamacare will worsen insurance coverage. Doesn't matter, though. They're teaching you that it's bad and there's nothing you can do about it. That's the real going off the cliff. And now, yeah, we're going to take your bank account data, and then we're going to take your bank account for not buying Obamacare, even though you're unable to. And yeah, we're going to debit your bank account. Because they love you so much. I mean, this is the total breaking of the society. In news that will surprise no one, NSA has cracked mobile phone encryption to listen to your calls. I mean, that's out of tech nerd, folks. I mean, that's like saying sunlight has learned how to go through the atmosphere. This is always, or that stars twinkle. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are up there in the sky so bright. Like a diamond in the night. Is that how it goes? They could probably tell people that, 2 + 2 = 5. They do that. And that stars are really, pinholes in a curtain or something. I mean, I'm telling you, the public will believe anything if they tell you it's racist not to believe it. If you don't believe that the stars are really pinholes in a blanket up in the sky, then you're a racist. There, people will actually, because I said that, they will actually now believe that. Because if you tell them, do what I say or you're racist, they'll do it. There, that's an example of mind control. Of course the big telecoms gave them their encryption up front. I mean, the telecoms are the new world order. They are the big banks. They get paid to run all this. They get paid to steal from everybody. I need to not get in such a bad mood. Obama suppressing 6,000-page report on CIA torture adopted by Senate Intelligence Committee. Of course, the torture continues. After 100 years of failure, it's time to end the Fed, a new Ron Paul article up on Infowars.com. I was on Ron Paul's TV show today, but they keep that only down for subscribers and on some of the TV systems they're on. I think they need to get that out to everybody. But regardless, they're building a nice little network over there. I enjoyed being interviewed by Ron Paul, thought it was cool. And if we can find it on YouTube when it goes up later, we'll link it on Infowars.com. But it was really great to be interviewed by Ron Paul. It was so weird to be him looking at me on video, and I'm looking back at him on video. It was just different. After 100 years of failure, it's time to end the Fed. Also got stuck in traffic and was 15 minutes late for my interview. Usually on time. That was weird. Nico was sitting there while they were on Skype waiting for me to get here, and Ron Paul leans over in a friendly way and goes, I'm on time for his interviews. Continuing, North Korea troops pledge loyalty en masse as Seoul on alert. He's having his uncles and cousins and people executed for not properly worshiping him. And I think it's fitting in a hereditary dictatorship of communism that you have a third generation king who has ex-girlfriends executed as well. And hey, Romans 13, according to all the preachers here in town that badmouth me 24/7 to their practitioners and people that come in, their flock, the state is God. God put him there. We should all worship Kim Jong-un. Of course, the whole Bible's about resisting tyrants, but, you know. BP signs deal to develop $16 billion Omaha shale gas project. U.S. Navy helicopter crashes in Japan. Yemen parliament votes to ban drone attacks. That's not going to stop the New World Order Skynet from bombing people after they killed 15 more in a wedding last week. U.S. transfers two Guantanamo detainees to Saudi Arabia for special torture. George P. Bush says he's a Tea Party conservative, showing how much power the Tea Party has. He's not for the New World Order. I'm no Marxist, Pope Francis tells conservative critics. Yeah, I did read most of his big paper. He's not really calling for Marxism there. He's saying big mega banks and big powerful groups are setting up a system that's so scientific that no one even has an economy, and corporations and companies need to build a system that's sustainable for people to have jobs. And I actually agree with that. Capitalism is not coming in as corporations that control the government and shutting down your competition and using, you know, artificial trading systems that are fraudulent and bankrupting everyone, and then everyone goes broke so you can buy up everything they've got artificially. Fed could set off record end fireworks if they do have quantitative easing. I don't think they will, folks, because if they do stop quantitative easing, it will cause fireworks, but I don't think they will stop the QE unlimited because it's two different poisons. Pick your poison. That's just some of the news on that front. Consumer Reports ask, are too many kids taking antipsychotic drugs? None of them should be taking it. U.S. explores ties with Syrian Islamist rebels, possibly Assad too, for a lineup to fight al-Qaeda. That is just pure propaganda being put out to act like they're distancing themselves from al-Qaeda, which they publicly run. That's really hurt the New World Order with the U.S. military, finally waking them up to a deep level. And then I've got a whole deal where the New York Post is coming out talking about the Saudi Arabian connection to 9/11. And basically confirming what I said and others pointed out about the Saudi Arabian connection that got covered up. So they've gone from demonizing people that talk about that to now basically admitting all of that. Whole families murdered by Syrian rebels, execute over 80 civilians outside Damascus in one day alone. That's RT. Surprise, mainstream media, Fox News admits GMOs are a real safety issue. Prisonplanet.com article. That's a really important article we need to get on InfoWars. I didn't see this on InfoWars. We asked them to put that on InfoWars. I know there's a lot of different news on Prison Planet, which is good. It's good to have the sites be somewhat different. But we need to get that on InfoWars if it's not. In fact, I'll just give it to you. Here you go. Very important video report. Documents reveal states move to vastly expand continuity of government. In Washington, the feds are lobbying to have the states suspend their constitution and basically allow martial law. The documents up on InfoWars.com. Christmas under assault, a New American article. I got a call from CNN today going, do you agree with Megyn Kelly that Santa Claus is white? And I said, yeah. And they go, well, we don't need any more guests. We were just calling to see your opinion. I guess it's going to be in some piece to go extremist like Alex Jones. Thinks he's white. That's racist. They said last week on the news that you should have only black Santas or other Santas. It's mean to have any icon that's white because white is evil. Folks, if you have other mythical creatures or other mythical people, you can look up African, children deities or whatever. They have them that are similar. If we followed that here, it would say it was black, that the character was black. Yeah, there it is. Santa Claus should not be a white anymore. That is the headline from Slate. And then it goes through the different pundits that are saying it. It's time to give Saint Nick his long overdue makeover. Well, I mean, my whole issue here is that this shows how, why not just make other mythical characters? Like the Federal Reserve claims it's federal. Why not, you know, why not actually make it federal? No, no, I'm being sarcastic. The point is, if you have, say, Superman that's supposedly white, why say it's racist to make Superman white? Let's make him black. Or who's a famous superhero that's black? Give me an example of that. I don't really follow superheroes. There's a bunch of them I know. I mean, do they have to be white now? And that's kind of what Santa Claus is like a superhero. So the whole point is it's somebody from the North Pole, somebody from Northern Europe. It comes from the Netherlands, where he's white for 500 years. And so why do you have to make him another color then to make everybody else happy? It's kind of like mother and father upsets gays and lesbians. Well, who says? Who speaks for them anyways? So you can't say mother and father on your official documents because that's hurtful. This is just literal mind control training us that we can't have any culture but 2 + 2 = 5. The only culture is mental illness. The only culture is not knowing facts. Power Man. There you go. Well, I think Power Man should have to be white or Hispanic. There's a bunch of other black superheroes. I mean, I can't even keep track of it all. But, you know, there's like black Green Lanterns. They need to be white. I mean, this is just pointless, ladies and gentlemen. It's like all these debates about what color Jesus was or whatever. Fine, make him whatever color you want. In fact, make Santa Claus. I've been in places and seen a black Santa Claus. I wasn't offended by it. Who even cares? But, I mean, if you had a black character and then you made him white, would that be offensive? I don't think so if you just did it for your event or wanted to have fun. But to make it an issue. See, we shouldn't even be talking about this. We should be talking about the inequity. We should be talking about the problem in society where you've got foreign banks ruining all of our futures, devaluing all of our dollars, shutting down all of our power plants. That is our power plants collectively. They're not shutting physically all of them down, but they are all our power plants that we've paid for with our money. Our bills, and it's all being, we're all being selectively robbed of our future, all being spied on by the NSA. I mean, it's like if you go see the movie Thor, I saw the first one, I haven't seen the new one, and, you know, they've got the black gatekeeper at Asgard. I wasn't offended that they put a black character in there, even though it comes out of Norse mythology where there were no black people in Northern Europe, in Viking Europe. In Viking, you know, Atlantic Ocean. So why would you do that? I mean, it'd be like if you were, if I went and watched a movie about fictitious Zulu war, Zulu character, expecting there to be white Zulus for political correctness sake. I mean, I guess that is kind of what Tarzan is, so we can have a white hero in Africa. So I guess that is basically what's going on. It's the mindlessness of all this. Totally and completely mindless. Let me go ahead here and go to your phone calls, and I'll go back into that news that I mentioned dealing with Saudi Arabia. You know, is it racist that 15 of the 19 hijackers came from Saudi Arabia? Is it right that I'm pointing out they're from Saudi Arabia? Is that really an anti-Arab sentiment? That's the kind of thing CNN would ask. Back when Clinton was selling all our secrets out to the communist Chinese leadership, CNN called me once. I don't think they even had me on. Most of the time they call, they don't have you on. And they go, we know on your radio show, we're just to have conservatives on. And I'm like, I'm really a libertarian, thank you, constitutionalist, that you know, there's a lot of criticism of China and missile secrets and things. Are you saying that because you're against Chinese people? And I said, excuse me? That's like if you criticize Israeli espionage, they'll say it's anti-Semitic. No, I don't want the Chinese involved in espionage. I don't want the white president at the time involved in espionage. I don't want the Israelis involved in espionage. I don't want the Russians involved in espionage. And it's not because I dislike Russians. It's not because I dislike Jews. It's not because I dislike Arabs. I dislike being stolen from. I dislike being screwed with. I dislike being robbed. But see, they want to change the subject, ladies and gentlemen. The controlled media at first wouldn't say most of the knockout game is racist blacks targeting whites and others until Al Sharpton knew it was going to blow up in their face, so he came out and said it needs to stop because it was inherently a racial attack that was going on. The media is so controlled that that's what they do because they're not wedded to covering up black-on-white crime. That's not what it is. They're wedded on keeping the divide and conquer going, but doing it from a leftist perspective. Let's go to some phone calls here. JD in California, thanks for holding. Good to hear from you.
Yep, straight to the point. I had an idea about, after seeing what happened with you in Dallas and talking about suing the Pittsburgh police and stuff, I was thinking maybe we need a team of specialized protesters in every city that know how to take a beating without fighting back, and have a team of lawyers that work pro bono and to start exposing it and get some funding for the info war in the time. In the meantime.
You know, here's my issue. I agree they're violating the First Amendment everywhere under federal guidelines, and it's important to sue, and we have sued Pittsburgh and won. I haven't sued the sheriff's department because it was really the feds that ordered it, and I kind of got to pick my battles. I mean, I could probably, good chance, win a lawsuit, but I mean, it's taxpayer money. Somebody else needs to do it because I literally can't even keep my operation going to the next level if I get distracted. But I do think it's important for people to stop bowing to government. We've bowed to government so long, the government thinks the proper citizen position is on our knees or bent over a barrel.
Oh, yeah, exactly.
I mean, literally, I expect the new salute to the police is bend over, grab your ankles. I'm not joking. I mean, they're doing proctology exams all over the U.S. now, viciously, without even probable cause, because it's all an act of domination over us, their food.
Well, because most people do sit there and take it because everyone's been taught that you can't fight the government, that they are too big, too powerful, and that you might as well just, you know, you're a lot safer to just go along with it and just, you know, keep quiet and let them do their thing.
Very well said, brother. Anything else?
I'll let you get the next caller, man. Amen.
This just popped up on drudgereport.com. We're going to put it up on infowars.com. This is a top story. You know they've used the gun database in New York, Illinois, to then come confiscate guns. California now has a gun database, and they're going to use it to confiscate guns. In fact, they're already taking legal guns, and this is in the Sacramento Bee. It goes on to break down that they've begun the national database through the states, and California Department of Justice will retain information on long gun purchases. Data it had formerly been compelled to destroy within 5 days. Dealers will need to register purchases with the state, and they will use that to confiscate your guns. You cannot buy guns in California. I'm telling you, folks, you're in deep trouble. We're back live. Final segment. We'll jam in a few final phone calls here. Maybe do some overdrive. Take the rest of the calls from Terry and Mike and Tony and Michael and a few others. Here's some good news on the gun-grabbing front. Sheriffs refuse to enforce laws on gun control all over Colorado and other areas of the country. They're just pointing out they're not going to persecute people. They're not going to take people to jail that have a 30-round mag just because it might have been purchased after the ban. And that they're not, I mean, they've already nullified not arresting illegal aliens nationwide, and that's against the law to not do that. If something's not constitutional, don't follow it. Inside the Saudi 9/11 cover-up, this is from New York Post, and it's basically everything we put in my 9/11 films. The fact that the 15 hijackers were working for the U.S. government, they were protected. We don't know what really happened. We just know it's a cover-up. Just like Tamerlan Tsarnaev was working for the CIA. That's confirmed. There was a drill. There was a stand-down. There was a cover-up. They tried to kill both brothers. The other brother said he's not guilty. I'm telling you, folks, it's a setup. So Murdoch's New York Post today backs something we put out. Here we go. Google's racing robots give Amazon's drones a run for their money. Yeah, you can forget drones delivering packages. That's a PR stunt. 18-wheelers and cars delivering packages and freight by robot. They're already getting all the laws passed to do that. Then they're going to say the robots are safer than you. It's already begun. And then ban you from driving. First, they're going to charge you more. Russia has stationed Iskander missiles in Western region with nukes, threatening to basically nuke Europe. I mean, this is getting serious. Meanwhile, the police are all being trained to take on the American people during a collapse scenario. And I know the average police are not bad. I want to say that because I've learned that. But you better be doing something to speak out against this and say no. And that's starting to happen. There's a lot of good news happening, but the battle is on and the globalists push. We push back. They stop. Then they push back when we quit. We've got to want to win it, just like a football game. Stay in it for four quarters, 100%. We will beat them. We have the moral high ground, but it's going to take serious focus. Finally, in this hour, we have personally branded the highest quality dash cam systems with a free 4 gig megabyte system, high def, that can videotape wildlife, the police when they're out of control, road ragers, double rainbows, whatever the case is. I use it in my car. I'm going to shoot a video showing it later in the next few weeks. We have these discounted $30 less than the leading competitor of the exact same system. This is $150 to $130. We have it for $99.95 with the free memory stick. High def at InfoWarsStore.com. At InfoWarsLife.com, which also takes you to InfoWarsStore.com, we have 25% off for the next 48 hours on Fluoride Shield. It has the nascent iodine in it, but five other key ingredients that turbocharge the other Survival Shield nascent iodine. When you get a bottle of nascent iodine for the regular price of $30, you get the 2-ounce bottle, double the size of Fluoride Shield, $10 off. So you get both bottles for $59.95. This is blows away the leading competitors. This stuff is very expensive to produce compared to other. I mean, I just got to tell you, I'm really getting into this, learning what's going on. This is the highest quality, and it supports the broadcast. InfoWarsStore.com, InfoWarsLife.com. And this is a great gift to give for Christmas. You can order it now. You'll get it way before Christmas. You'll guarantee get it the day before Christmas if you order by the 19th. But it's imperative here on the 16th, on this Monday. If you want to get some Wake Up America Patriot Blend, my personal favorite coffee from Southern Mexico, that's available at InfoWarsLife.com. If you want to get the silver or nickel bronze belt buckles and other Made in America apparel, a Made in America flag, that's blasphemy, not made in China by slaves. You can fly this baby, high-quality fabric, stitched. That's available for $24.95. I mean, can't get a Chinese slave flag for near that. So the whole point is it's all available at InfoWarsStore.com, and your purchase makes it all possible. And you can give a PrisonPlanet.tv membership this year at Christmas as well. And there I said it, Christmas, you Christmas, 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 and Santa Claus is white. And I know that's racist. The red hat is really a Klan hat, folks. I need to be arrested.
Alex Jones here with a message to fellow freedom lovers.
You know, we emailed Camille Paglia a few months ago, and she said she might come on in the new year, but she's too busy right now with a book and debating and everything. But I really want to get her on. It's up on Drudge Report right now, drudgereport.com. It's a man's world, and it will always be. The modern economy is a male epic in which women have found a productive role, but women were not its author. Well, men are the strength of women, and women are the strength of men. But I want to cover more of this article tomorrow because I really agree with her breakdown on society. Really a genius level lady. And a real liberal, I would use that term like a Thomas Jefferson type, for real freedom and real empowerment of men and women together. Not a war between men and women played off by the controlled left. Let's talk to Terry in Illinois. Terry, you're on the air. Thanks for holding. Welcome.
Hi, Alex. How you doing?
Good, brother. Good.
Hey, I wanted to compliment you on your son's interview you did with the fun facts and the science that he had. You need to make him an anchor. Give him an anchor.
He loves to talk. He's smarter than I am, 11 years old. And we've almost got Mama convinced to let him come down here and work one day a week in the office. But
Well, think about it like this. You'll reach a whole different audience, and the young ones will listen to him because he's so intelligent and he knows what he's talking about.
I know. I mean, he doesn't want to be on the air to be famous. He could care less about stuff like that. He could care less about Hollywood and all the rest of the stuff, but he really loves to talk to people, and he is a great son. It's one of my greatest blessings.
Well, it'll help reach new audience. Now, the thought that I have, did you know anything about the Batman movie when it came out in the fall? They show Batman standing at a desk. Guess what's written on the desk?
Sandy Hook.
And then the neon sign.
Sir, we said that the.
Hold on a second. And the background, Aurora, Colorado, 30 minutes later in the same movie.
I know.
And that came out in the fall, and Sandy Hook and Aurora happened in the spring.
Did you know we said that Batman would be used for triggers of operatives, mind control operatives, before the movie came out?
Did you know the name of that movie is The Dark Knight Rises?
I did. And Bane, I said, is supposed to be a French Revolution character. And later, the writer of it admitted that. And okay, people said, and the national media said, I'm not trying to one-up you. I'm just agreeing with you.
Hey, I don't have much time, so you got to let me get here. Proverbs 29:2 says, when someone wicked rules, the people sigh.
God bless you. Very well said, brother. Great call, Terry. Let's talk to Bill in North Carolina. No, Bill's not next. It's Michael. Michael, you're on the air in Arizona.
In Arizona.
Yeah, Michael, how you doing?
Hello, Alex. Nice to talk to you again. Still look forward to meeting with you. I tell you what, I remember you, what you just said about that Batman movie. I remember you predicting that, your prediction. And I don't watch those things, man. I watch documentaries.
Well, that's, again, it's not that all movies have subliminals. We've learned that.
But you called it out before it came out. And I remember that, brother.
Well, thank you. But the point is that it's not every movie. We've learned that franchise is used for programming. Go ahead.
Right on. Yeah. Okay. My thing is, what I want to say today, and I'll make it real quick. I've got a couple of examples, and I've got another one coming up. Is how they, whether it's local, federal, state, or whatever, they'd like to sugarcoat things. Oh, I mean, Obamacare, when they first started talking about it, when Obama first came into office, it sounded like a good thing until it went to hell. Excuse my language. Drones. I got out of the military in 92. They came out with drones, and they were saying back then, you know, in the early 90s, they were going to monitor battlefields. Okay, that's fine. That sounds good. That's going to save our...
No, but now they're making it a battlefield here. What was your other point?
When they weaponized them, I thought to myself, being a veteran myself, which means I'm a racist, I guess, or a terrorist or whatever, but I said, that's going to be trouble.
You said 2 + 2 = 4... and use common sense, and thinking for yourself is conspiracy theory, and that's why it's illegal and wrong. 2 + 2 = 5. The Genesis.